Hey everyone, welcome back to VinVout. In today's video, we'll be looking at how to make a matrix keypad and understand how it works. A matrix keypad is a common input device used in many electronic projects. It allows users to input data or make selections through a combination of rows and columns. This configuration can be seen in our keyboards. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of building your own matrix keypad and explain the underlying working principles. I made a matrix keypad myself for another project, and one of my subscribers asked me if I could explain it a bit more. And here you go.
You only need few components. Like here I have 8 push buttons since I'm making a 2x4 matrix. If you are using a 3x4 or 4x4, you need 12 buttons. I'll talk about it later. And you also need some wires. Since you are making it on a breadboard, of course, you need a breadboard.
So how do we normally use a push button with our Arduino? We'll connect one pin to the ground and we'll use the internal pull-up resistor of the Arduino and connect it to one of these digital pins, right? So what happens when we push it? It will be pulled up to 0 volts, and when I release it, it will go to a high state. In some cases, we need more push buttons. For example, when you want to make a keyboard, you will definitely need more, and you can't connect all of them to your Arduino because you do not have that much GPIO pins free. So there, we will use this technique of the matrix keypad. It's actually a technique used for reducing the number of pins used by these push buttons. So if I was going to connect all of these individually to our microcontroller, we would have been using 8 GPIO pins, right? But now I'm only using 6 of them.
Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
It only needs 6 rather than 8. In the case of 4x4 matrix, we get 16 push buttons. So theoretically speaking, we will need about 16 GPIO pins, and that's a lot. You won't be able to connect other sensors or modules or whatever you want to connect. So, but when you are using this 4x4 matrix keypad arrangement, you will only be using 8 GPIO pins. Similarly, if you are using 4x3 matrix keypad, you would get 12 keys. And it only needs 7 GPIOs. That's the use of this matrix keypad arrangement.
This is the schematic, or this is how you need to connect it. I think it's a bit confusing, so you can look at this.
This is a 3x4 matrix. Consider these round white things as switches, and this is a 3x4 matrix. We have 3 rows and 4 columns. So these green represents the column wires, and this represents the row wires.
If you look closely, you can see that we have connected it in the same way. We have the column lines, we also have the row lines. I actually took out the wires from the insulation and connected one wire's head to another one's tail in the same breadboard hole. We connect this to a microcontroller which can scan these lines for a button pressed state. The microcontroller sets all the column and row lines to input, then the microcontroller sets row as low. After that, it checks the column lines one at a time. If the column connection stays high, the button on the row has not been pressed. When we press a button, it shorts one of the row lines to one of the column lines, allowing the current to flow between them. So for example, when the third button of the first row is pressed, it creates a path for the current to flow between the first row and third column. Finally, it knows which button was pressed that corresponds to the detected row and column. Select the library manager from the tools and type in keypad, scroll down and find the one by community https://github Chris a keypad, install it. Now go to the examples. There you have the keypad. Select hello keypad. This one is for 4x3 matrix keypad. We need to make some modifications in order to work with our 2x4 matrix keypad. So first we include the keypad library. Then we have the number of rows and columns defined, and here we give the output of the button presses or the things we need to print on serial monitor while pressing the switches. You can see it is also in the 4x3 arrangement. Next we have the pinout to which we have to connect our keypad matrix. Next, an object called keypad is created using the makeyMap function and passing in the keys, row pins and column pins as arrays and the number of rows and columns. And we use the getKey method to read the key presses from the keypad in the loop. And we just print it using the serial.println. Here we have the modified code for our 4x2 or 2x4 matrix keypad. And we have changed the number of columns and rows. We have also modified how the output of the button presses would look. It is also in the 2x4 or 4x2 arrangement. And we have also changed the pinouts, and the rest are the same.